This GVC module is a hamster wheel. It has a lot of tiny details, both technical, but also details like the little hamster actually running around. Let's take a look at all the tiny details there are, and then see it running for a couple of minutes. The main part of the wheel are these pockets that I've added transparent elements to so that you can see what's going on. The wheels get into the wheel, or the balls come into the wheel from this hole down here when they are on the bottom. Then they get pulled around, and as you can see right now, these two balls are held by this wedge. This is done so they don't just fall out and into the wheel again. So when they come from this side, they lie with gravity on this side of the hole, but as soon as we cross over the top, they will pull to the other side where they hold by the wedge. And as soon as the wheel has turned enough, gravity will pull them out and over this hole and into the outbox. You can see as we are turning, gravity will start pulling more in this direction, which will make the wheels or the balls jump out like this. And this outbox right here is big enough to catch the balls, whether they come jumping out from up here or all the way down here into the outbox. So you can see right here, there are four balls. They're being held by the wedge, but as soon as we go all the way to this side, they jump out. Now, once in a while, when there's just a single ball, it has a tendency to actually jump the wedge and jump out of the hole. So we can draw it right here. Then it would jump out like that. And in order to prevent that ball from escaping the great ball contraption, we have pretty tall guards on the side. As you can see, when they're falling from up here, the guards will prevent them from jumping out of the module. Balls might try to escape from this side, which is why we have this contraption to help push them back in if they try to escape. So now I'm running on low speed, and we might be lucky and see an escape attempt. Let's see if you can see right there. Try to push it in, of course the balls would otherwise have fallen outside of the machine. The hamster has had her legs replaced with wheels because she's running in this wheel for quite a while, and having wheels instead of legs will ease that task. Now, she is just held up by this cross axle in here. It connects to her tail so that she can run like this. There will be a lot of balls falling down, some of them are hitting her, but she seems to not care. Now, when the balls fall down here, of course they're held by the guards. And apart from that, we have this little wedge on this side, which makes sure that when there are only a few balls in here, they still get pushed around so that they will eventually fall into the holes. This single axle motor runs the whole module, and it can be placed here, here, and similarly on the other side, depending on how it's mostly convenient when you're exhibiting the module. The module does turn, so the inbox is on the back side, but the outbox is inside, so it fits nicely as a corner of a larger exhibition. And we can actually run this module from just the speed of one. You can even run it from half speed. And of course, if you run it on full speed, it shouldn't break, but I recommend running it on speed 1. You run like this. Let's just for fun see what it is in 3.6. Yeah, I recommend running it on speed 1.